Welcome! In this video, you will learn how to send various queries to read and write data in a database using Prisma Client. For this demo, I'll also use Prisma Studio to get a graphical view on my data. Right now, I have two user records in the database. One of them already is connected to two post records. The same data we just saw in Prisma Studio is returned by the current Prisma Client query when the script is executed. Note that Prisma Client always returns query results as plain old JavaScript objects, which makes it easy to reason about the queries that are sent to the database and the data they return. With TypeScript, all of Prisma Client's query results are statically typed. For example, I can include the posts relation on the returned user objects, and the resulting type for these objects will be inferred. To go even further, I can also select specific fields on the returned post objects. The returned data is typed accordingly so that I cannot accidentally access a property that was not retrieved from the database. This is an incredibly powerful feature of Prisma Client, which vastly increases the confidence I can have in my code and makes it easy to refactor in the future. Next, I'll create a new user record in the database using a create query and provide the required data. In fact, I'm using a nested write query to already create a post record that will be immediately connected to the user record in my database. Notice how I'm using the autocompletion of my editor, which guides me through the Prisma Client API. Lastly, I'll send a query to update a post record and set its published field to true. After the query was sent, the published field has been flipped to true in the database. That's it for this video. In the next video, you will learn how you can evolve the application by adding a new table to the database and regenerating Prisma Client.